In this video, we'll be looking at Google Sites and Blogger. Google Sites and Blogger are both easy ways that you can put information on the web fast. They are both Google products, so they will both work with your Kenyon user ID and password, since we're a Google Apps school. That said, because they're Google products, they also provide some easy pathways if a student, faculty, or staff member wants to migrate content to their personal Google address. Both Blogger and Google Sites allow for multiple authors on the site, making them good for group projects, although good in different ways, and we'll talk about that in a moment. Both of them are designed to make public websites, but it's very easy in both systems to restrict your website to a particular group of other authors and readers. Blogger makes blogs. It makes a reverse chronological arrangement of blog posts. And that is what you will get from virtually all of their designs, central column listing those posts as they come along. Most of your users will look at a Blogger site as a reverse chronological list of posts. It can also, however, be navigated by subject labels. You can put a tag on each post, and then that list of tags provides another way for your readers to see related posts on a particular subject. If you get into Blogger's editing tool, you'll see immediately that it's really designed to privilege text. You can do a lot with images and with embedded media in your site, but the writing tool is clearly thinking about writing text first. Now, we said that Blogger allows for multiple authors. In Blogger, each post is identified with the person that wrote it. The author is clearly part of the design, which if you want to project the different people who are involved in a project, that can be very useful. By default, Blogger has comments turned on. You can turn this off if it's not appropriate, but if you want to interact with your readers, Blogger is a better platform for that. And Blogger publishes sites to a name that you define at blogspot.com. Google Sites is designed to really privilege the visual look of your site. A Google site looks more like a fully functional website and less like a blog. And the tools that they've got to help you find a pleasing arrangement on your of elements on your page are easy to learn and pretty slick. That said, you do give up some control over the elements of your design, like fonts, colors, font sizes. Google has provided a relatively small number of templates, and you've got a restricted amount of ability to customize them. This may be a benefit or a hindrance, depending on your goals. But it does give you a drag and drop interface to move things around on your page, which is much more powerful than what is available to you working with Blogger. They have done a lot to embed various other Google products, including files from your Google Drive, Google Maps, YouTube videos, that are all embedded within the authoring tool for Google Sites. Google Sites can be edited by a group, but the authorship is not on each and every page. It can look a little bit more like one cohesive group project, and on the other hand, you may have to actually add text citations if you want to make it clear that different pages have been written by different people. And then Google Sites live at an address on sites.google.com, and when you're doing it through Kenyon, that's followed by /kenyon.edu, and then slash the name that you find. So Google Sites URLs are a little longer. How do we get started? Since these are easy to get started with and free, the best way is probably to start playing around. If you want to try out a blog, go to blogger.com. You can sign in with your Kenyon or your personal Google account, and you'll click New Blog to start setting up a new blog where you can write some posts, see how they look, see how you can organize them with labels. To get started with Google Sites, you actually go into your Google Drive at drive.google.com. Again, sign in with either your Kenyon or your personal Google account and click the New button, the same button that you'd start to do a new Google Doc or slide or sheet. In the menu, you want to go to the bottom of that menu and click on More, and then click on Google Sites to start a new site and start editing the pages on it. Thanks very much.